Proxima B is the closest exoplanet. Could there be life there? In 2019, the Parkes Observatory in Australia detected a strange radio signal that seemed to come from the Alpha Centauri star system. After an arduous analysis, scientists ruled out that this signal came from outer space, since it was most likely a signal from some artificial satellite. While an extraterrestrial civilization did not send this signal, it reawakened the enthusiasm of the scientific community to find life outside our planet, especially since the Alpha Centauri system has the exoplanet Proxima B, which is quite similar to Earth. Ready? Let's get started. Let's compare it with Earth to find out what possibilities there are that life exists in Proxima B. Proxima B has a radius of 1:1 concerning the Earth and a mass of 1.27 Earth masses. This means that both have very similar size and masses, only that Proxima B is a little larger. It's also in the habitable zone of its star, has a surface temperature that oscillates between minus 39 degrees Celsius, and has all the conditions to harbor water on its surface. But the similarities end there. Proxima B does not orbit a star like a sun, but orbits the star Proxima Centauri, a red dwarf-type star. This type of star is characterized because they are not so hot and emit jets of radiation spontaneously, which can tear the atmosphere of a planet like Proxima B. In addition, although this exoplanet orbits within the habitable zone, this region is much closer to its star than our solar system's habitable zone. For example, if we were to place the habitable zone of Proxima Centauri in our solar system, it would be much closer than the orbit of Mercury. This means that Proxima B orbits very close to its star, so the effects of radiation and gravity must be felt intensely, affecting its atmosphere and even its rotation. Extreme solar flares. Unfortunately, any life that can call that planet home will have a hard time. Proxima Centauri is a red dwarf star with only a fraction of the mass of the Sun. Because of their small size, the nuclear fusion cores of red dwarf stars are much closer to their surfaces. This makes their surfaces much more chaotic than stars like the Sun, and that increased turbulence amplifies powerful magnetic fields. Those solid magnetic fields can launch powerful bursts of radiation and high-energy particles into the surrounding system. At distances far enough from a star, this is no big deal. But because stars like Proxima Centauri aren't as luminous as the Sun, their habitable zones are much closer. Close enough that habitable is too generous of a word. Although astronomers already felt that life on Proxima B would be tough, they did not know the exact location of the magnetic field around Proxima Centauri. Instead, they had to rely on observations of similar stars. A new study used high-resolution maps of Proxima Centauri's magnetic field to develop a model of the solar wind emanating from that star. They found that, with the most accurate information, the situation is as bleak as we thought. Proxima B receives about 1,000 times more solar wind radiation than Earth. This would make it extremely difficult for the planet to harbor an atmosphere, let alone liquid water. While it doesn't completely rule out the possibility of life in that world, it does mean that any life that has arisen there has a much harder time surviving than we do. Simulations have shown that if Proxima B has an atmosphere or magnetic field similar to Earth's, then, and only then, life on its surface might be possible. But without that protective barrier, any life on this exoplanet will most likely disappear regularly because of the high radiation levels. Also, if the planet has a thin atmosphere or no magnetic field, it might not be as promising a place for life as we expected. Until we can observe the planet more closely, either ourselves or with a high-power telescope, we won't have any clear answers. Gravity could play in favor. Although the star orbiting Proxima B emits solar flares, if it has a magnetic field and a dense atmosphere, this could protect the living beings that live there. The good news is that this exoplanet could have an atmosphere. In a new study, an international team of researchers found Proxima B to be 17% more massive than our planet. Previously, scientists thought that this exoplanet, which lies in its star's habitable zone, harbored a minimum of around 1.3 Earth masses. The new measurement indicates that Proxima B could look even more like our home planet, at least in size, than previous observations led scientists to think. This means that if it had enough mass, it could also have a gravitational attraction force so great that it would not let its atmosphere escape, even if there were constant solar flares. However, this same factor could play against it, since having a lot of mass and at the same time being so close to its star, Proxima B could present tidal coupling. Tidal coupling occurs when a celestial body gives the same face at all times to the body it orbits. An example is the Moon, which is gravitationally coupled to the Earth. Therefore, we always see the same face of the Moon. In the case of Proxima B, the same thing could happen. This planet could have one of its faces always pointing at its star, so that on one side of its sides, it would be eternal at day and on the other, eternally at night. Although tidal coupling does not prevent living beings, it would make the presence of life quite difficult because the atmospheric conditions would be extreme. The side of the exoplanet that is always pointing at the star would be a hot hell like Venus, while the side that is in the dark would be frozen entirely. The only area where there could be life would be in the sunrise strip between the hot and the cold zone. This region could have much more pleasant temperatures and even liquid water. But what is the authentic atmosphere of this planet? Ocean world. For sure, it's not known how the atmosphere of Proxima B is, since it does not pass in front of its star like other exoplanets that are discovered through stellar transit. Because of this, we cannot study its composition and determine if it has water, oxygen, ice, or an atmosphere. We know that this exoplanet is very similar in size, weight, and distance to many other exoplanets found in the galaxy. So analyzing it with pure statistics indicate that it is an oceanic planet. The oceanic planets are characterized because they are covered with an ocean of liquids, including water. If so, this world could host aquatic beings that adapt to the harsh temperatures, avoiding going to the surface and staying permanently in the ocean's depths. It could also be that if temperatures are low enough, the outermost layer of the exoplanet freezes, ultimately turning it into a snowball planet, much like the moon of Jupiter, Europa. Europa is a natural satellite wholly covered in ice, but it is known that there may be an ocean of liquid water beneath all those thick ice sheets. If Proxima B is a world with similar conditions, living beings could protect themselves from radiation by taking refuge under the ice sheets of the exoplanet. In addition, if this world also has volcanism, as with underwater volcanoes on Earth, living beings could adapt to darkness with bioluminescence and survive without problems for thousands of years, acquiring the heat of the seabed and protecting itself from the radiation under the ice sheets. Different ways of life. Another option that many scientists and astrobiologists propose is that a new type of different from the Earth could emerge in Proxima B. Until now, we've always looked for carbon-based life that requires water, since that is how life works on Earth. But it is probable that on other planets with entirely different chemistry and conditions, living beings different from us could arise with unknown morphology and needs. In this case, many suggest that with the conditions of Proxima B, it would be enough for a type of life to emerge that does not require the amounts of oxygen that we need and that can survive shallow temperatures on the sea floor, adapt, and evolve. Some even speculate that there is no need to invent living beings with different chemistries, like the silicon-based extraterrestrials that Carl Sagan once imagined. It would be enough if Proxima B had the minimum conditions to sustain an atmosphere dense enough for extremophile bacteria to emerge, which exists here on Earth. These organisms can survive very extreme environments, from the boiling calderas of geysers to the ice sheets of Antarctica. If this exoplanet can sustain an environment at least a little similar to those two scenarios, that would be enough to be able to have living beings in the form of tiny bacteria. Unfortunately for all scientists and dreamers, we cannot check if Proxima B has volcanism, atmosphere, or water. For now, everything is an enigma. As this exoplanet cannot be observed by stellar transit, everything we know about it has been concluded through simulations. Of course, this does not mean that nothing that has been said is speculation. It simply means that we must wait for technology to continue advancing to have more information that helps us know what this world is like. For now, we know that it exists, that it is there waiting for us to discover all its mysteries. And considering how curious and ambitious the human race is, we will indeed discover it very soon.